Lydia Des Dolles, MA Connect TV, and I'm here at the Three Arena for KSW 40 with the victorious Paul Redmond. Congrats.
Thank you very much.
Split decision win.
Yeah, I mean, I was in the cage and they were calling it out in Polish. I didn't understand what they were saying, and then I heard my name being called, and then I thought that was the announcement for me just winning.
Yeah.
Then they called Lucas's name. I looked at Andy and I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And then they said split decision for me. I don't even think there was a 29-28 at all to him. I mean, I don't think there's a round to him whatsoever.
Yeah.
From me personally being in there, I thought it was a 30-27. That's me being biased. I don't know. I have to watch it back from my performance in there. I thought it was a 30-27.
I think all of us on press row as well, we were kind of the same. But look, sorry, my voice scum. Mm-hmm. I was screaming, that's why. Like, come on, Red. But we did think that you took the three rounds. Was he as you expected, or he looked tough in there? Like,
yeah, you know, I really cracked him with some big shots, really big shots. You know, I felt it in my right hand. The guy's got a hard head.
Yeah.
I probably should have been doing a little bit more. What my coaches were asking, they were calling for certain combinations. Probably wasn't listening to them as much. Not that I wasn't listening, just in there you might feel a combination is there and you might throw,
yeah,
but they might see something a little bit different that you can't see, maybe an angle, maybe he's putting his foot down in a different way and there's a leg kick there, you know, so maybe that's something I have to work on. I thought my hands looked a little bit better in there tonight, so always improve.
Mm-hmm. What about the takedown? He looked like he was defending the takedown a couple of times toward the third.
Yeah.
Were you trying to get him on the ground? Was that part of the plan? Yeah. I mean, that is your game, you know.
You know, we were saying that from the start, you know. I knew he was a strong judo guy. I knew he was going to go for the takedown, which he did. Didn't really get anything going off the takedown, so I don't think the takedown for him really scores. You know, in the rules, they say if you get a takedown, you got to pass the guard, you got to work, got a better position. He took me down, and then I was active. I went for the submission and stuff like that. You know, so I don't think the takedown was really big for him. I defended all his takedowns. His other ones, he defended some of mine. He had defense a couple of times, which the ref didn't see or didn't call him on. Which I probably could have got one or two takedowns from, but got him down at the end. Maybe then straight back to his feet. So yeah.
So I know this is obviously your first time in KSW. In the lead up to this, there was a little bit of, you know, stuff online. Andy done a couple of interviews where he was talking about promotions. I know you're not a fan of, you know, drama or publicity and all that kind of stuff.
There were certain things that, like Andy said, he had. He wanted to vent. He vented, it got cleared up, and now we're at where we're at.
Exactly.
That's it. There's no malice, there's nothing there. If Bama wanted to fight, whoever or whatever, they'll send me a contract, and it's that. We're still on good terms. Everybody thinks like, we're this, and this with Bama. We're not. We're still on good terms. We're still under contract.
Yeah.
And I will fight for Bama again. There's, you know, so don't worry about that.
100%.
I think everybody read into it way more.
Yeah.
Andy just wanted to vent his frustrations. He did it. That was the platform to do it on. We got some things cleared up.
Is this kind of an approach that you enjoy? You know, a promotion comes forward, we have a fight from I jump in, I take that. Like,
yeah.
Is that the way you prefer to go?
Yeah, I mean, look, I did sign a contract with KSW and I'm still under contract with Bama, so I can keep active with you. I just want to keep active as a fighter. It's not necessarily, I want to fight for those guys, I want to fight for these guys. Look, at the end of the day, I'm 31. I was 31 the other day.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, so... Look, I'm at the stage of my career now. I'm going to try and make as much money as I can from it. Not that MMA fighters do make a whole lot of money, but, okay, maybe I might get back to the UFC. Maybe. But look, there's good fights out there. I like to entertain people while I'm still young. Not many people will ever get the chance to do it. I'm good at it, so I may as well get paid for it.
Absolutely.
So that's where I'm at the minute, you know what I mean? So, KSW are paying well, and then... Yes, I'm happy.
Was the experience, how was a fight week? Was
brilliant.
It a good experience?
Couldn't have asked for anything more from KSW. Very professional round show. As soon as we landed with them on Friday, just as high level as you'd expect. Brought in, signed your posters, do your media. Left alone, that is good as gold. That's for me, you know. Your bus picture up here, this is your time. Everything is down to the absolute letter. One of the best promotions I've ever worked for.
Well, there you go, that's amazing. Before I let you go, I know that you had online during the week that the process of your reseller link.
Oh yeah.
The 125, so if anyone doesn't know, KSW do an individual link for each fighter. And if you buy the stream online, the fighter will get $1.25 per sale.
Yeah.
And you were donating all the funds to Temple Street Hospital.
They just sent, I didn't know that we were getting anything off the pay-per-view. They sent me out a link on Wednesday, I think. I says, look, I get my paycheck from KSW anyway. probably won't get a lot from that. Not that I think that's what I'm doing. Yeah. But whatever we get, we push it. And look, I'm going to throw a couple of hundred quid to Dan as well. So yeah, look, if we manage to get 500 quid up for him, it's 500 quid for the hospital.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Have,
you know, I think it's good for, you know, the scene as well, for the community, for people looking in that are not involved. They see people doing that. It does matter. You know what I mean? That they see, like, the MMA fighters.
They're not all assholes. They're not all barbarians.
There's a heart underneath it. But, you know, Neil done something similar in the past as well with a couple of things. Do you think that's important, you know, to give back to your community?
Yeah, I'd like to see maybe the promoters. I know they don't have to, I know they're not obliged. But look, every time they come, they make X amount, throw something to a charity or something like that. You know, just nobody likes to see little six kids out there and stuff like that. And, you know, we've got little nieces. And the reason I picked Temple Street was I've got two young nieces as well. And, you know, God forbid, to do it, hate that and see it happen to them. So, look, it's for a good cause, why not?
Absolutely. And before I let you go, final question. You're talking about your nieces. Is Therese here, your sister?
No, she's not. She didn't know it was on a Sunday. They went to get tickets. They thought it was a Saturday night as usual. They said, Paul, it's on a Sunday. And her boyfriend works really early, I should say. So he's got to sort of sleep. She's got to mind the baby. Okay. So she's not here tonight. And she is disgusted.
Yeah, I'd say she is, because she's always at every show. And I always see her. And she's always like, tell him, go backstage and tell him I said hello and I'm rooting for him. But listen, congratulations.
Thank
always
you
a pleasure
much.
To see you. And you deserve that win.
Thank you.
Paul Redmond.